Good morning. I'm Amanda, one of your Bold instructors. Today we're going to do an easy workout that is really nice to do in the mornings when you're just waking up, you're just feeling a little stiff, you want to get some circulation, and we'll be using a chair. So before we get started, make sure that you have a nice clear space where you can move freely. Make sure that you have a chair, preferably one that doesn't have wheels, that's nice and sturdy that you can sit in. And my safety reminder is that you should always listen to your body. If anything feels off, uncomfortable, or painful, go ahead and stop that exercise, easily back out of it, and skip it for this class. With that, let's get started. We're gonna bring our feet hips width apart. I want to really spread those toes out and let them rest on the floor. We're finding our bold base. So our knees and toes are pointing forward. Our hips are resting nice and heavy on the chair. Our shoulders will be stacked right over our hips. We're going to lift and lengthen our neck, imagining our ears are stacked over our shoulders. Let's just begin with three easy breaths. So we'll inhale and exhale. Good. Again, inhale. Taking in nice fresh air, expanding our belly, and exhale. One more time. Inhale. And exhale. Let's begin by warming up our shoulders. So we're just gonna bring our shoulders up to our ears and drop them down. Good. Again, up to the ears, both shoulders, and drop. And I'm thinking about the tops of my shoulders coming up to my ears. I'm also thinking about my shoulder blades on my back, lifting, sliding up, and dropping down. One more time, lifting up, and dropping down. Good. We're gonna start to move our arms. So we're just nice, easy. We're going to lift them up forward and let them come back down to our lap. Again, lift it up forward, and coming down. Now, as it's the morning and some of our shoulders might be stiff, they may not lift as high as we normally expect. That's okay. Nice and easy. Good. Now we're just going to take our right arm. So I'm mirroring. You just follow along. And lift it up. And lift it really high overhead. And then bring it back down. Good. Now, if you're able to, imagine those fingertips lifting high. And then opening to the side. Good. Lifting up and coming forward. Let's do that again. Same arm. Lifting up, opening to the side, lifting up and coming forward. One more time. Lifting up, opening to the side, lifting up and coming down. Good. Take a moment. Let's do the other side. Maybe your left arm comes up. Feel it nice and long, lengthening from the tip of our fingers down to our hips, still on that chair. And again, lift it up. This time we're gonna open it to the side and lift it up and bring it forward. Good. Now, sometimes you might feel a little bit of stickiness, moments where there's maybe a little click or sensation in your shoulder. Just take it nice and slow. Lift it up. And open, and up, and down. Let's do one more. Lift it up, and open, and up, and down. Bringing both hands to our lap, let's do our cat-cow movements. So we're gonna begin by exhaling and imagining our belly button is being connected and pulled towards the back of the chair. We're gonna drop our chin. And we're gonna start to find a little stretch from the tip of the head to the base of the spine. Good. And then we come up. That was our cat stretch, arching our back. And now we'll reverse, doing the cow. Just opening the chest, leaning slightly forward, tilting our hips forward. Good. And center. Let's do that again. Try and put the movements together so they move freely. Arching. And leaning, good, tilting forward and center. One more time. Cat, And coming up through this nice straight posture before we tilt it. We might even pull our shoulders a little bit closer together. And back to our seated bold base. Awesome, let's warm up those hands a little bit. So just starting with nice gentle fists and open, and fists and open, good. Fists, open, good. And let's just do some wrist circles. So nice and easy, really thinking about those wrists, looking at them, giving them a little bit of attention this morning, good. And let's reverse those circles, going the other direction. Nice. And pause. Open and close. Open. Trying to let go of that stiffness. Open. One more time. Open. This time we're going to take our right hand forward, flexing our palms, and very gently we'll just pull all five fingers back, getting a little bit of a wrist stretch, a forearm stretch. And shake it out. Other side. Like we're saying, stop flexing our palms, pulling all five fingers back, nice, gentle. Sometimes I like to bend my elbow as well. And release, shake it out. Good, let those hands come to the left. We're gonna imagine someone's got a belt around our middle section. They're tightening it up. So we're firming our belly button. We're squeezing it to the low part of our back and holding that strength, that strong center. We're going to begin marching. We're not gonna take it very fast. We're just gonna think about waking up, powering up, feeling that connection in the middle of our body. And a little bit of a challenge as we start to lift those knees. Good. You can leave those hands on those thighs. And if you want, you can start to pick up the pace. Keep holding that belly firm. You've got it. Okay. Do a few more marches. And pause. All right, now we're going to kick those knees forward. So flex foot, kick and down. Alternating legs. Good. And down. And out, and out, good. Now, as we're doing these kicks, I want you to still think about sitting up nice and tall, that beautiful, bold posture, and giving our body as much space as we can, starting off our morning strong, starting to wake up those legs. For 3, 2, 1, last kick, bring both feet down. Now we're going to extend one foot forward and just do some gentle ankle circles. Nice and easy. And reverse those ankle circles other direction. Good. Maybe you'll hear a snap, crackle, pop. That's okay. And put that foot down. Other side. Lifting it up, lengthening it forward, just some gentle ankle circles, waking it up. Good. Pause, other direction, really feeling each of those toes. We're looking for articulation, the ankle in the toes, wiggling them if you're wearing shoes. And pause, bring that foot down. Awesome. We're going to just do leg openers. We're going to open our leg out to the side, and in, other side, open and close. Again, open and close. Nice and easy, it might not be very wide. It's okay if it's just a few inches. We're just thinking about side, open and close, and open and close. And again, I want you to think about that belly button squeezing towards your lower back, and at the same time, lengthening that nice, beautiful posture. Awesome. 3, 2, 1, final movement, open and close and pause. Now we're gonna bring in a little bit of yoga movement today, bringing our hands to palms to meet each other. Bring those hands to the center of the chest. On our next inhale, we're going to reach those arms up nice and long. And on the exhale, we're going to start to melt our body forward. So you might just come to a forward lean with your hands on your thighs. You could also reach your hands to your calves or maybe down to the floor, nice and easy, nice and gentle forward fold. And very slowly with control, coming halfway up, hands to thighs, lengthen the back. And again, forward fold. Noticing as it gets easier, the more we practice. And then inhale, starting to sit up tall, letting those arms float. Palms meet, palms to the center. Good, let's do that two more times. Inhale, lift. We're waking up, we're greeting the sun. Exhale, fold it forward. Hands start to make their way down towards the ground as we fold forward. Inhale, coming halfway up, lengthening the back, lengthening the spine. Exhale, fold forward. Good. Inhale, slowly, carefully making our way. Nice, tall, seated position. Arms reach if you can, they meet. And back to the center. One more time. Let's go. Inhale, lift. Exhale. Start to fold forward, whichever level makes sense for you. Inhale, coming halfway up, lengthening. Exhale, fold it forward. And inhale, starting to sit up tall. Arms lifting. Palms meet. Back to the center of the chest. Good. That was nice. I hope that felt good for you too. Our next movement, we're going to take our two hands. We're going to make fists. We're going to think about strengthening the inner and outer parts of our legs. We're going to make two fists. We're going to put it between our knees, keeping those feet flat on the floor. I want you to just think about squeezing those fists in as you're trying to tighten and close those knees towards each other. Good. And if you're applying this tension, this movement, you're going to start to feel your inner thighs light up a bit. Activate. Good. Release. Let's do that again. Squeeze, bringing them together. Tummy still tight. And release. And squeeze one more time. Really trying to bring those knees together, but your fists are in the way. And release. Good. Shake out those hands. Give them a little bit of a break. We're going to bring our feet together, knees together. I like to think like you're zippering up down the center of your legs. And this time we're going to think about our butt. So hands on my thighs, sitting up tall. I'm not leaning back in my chair. And I'm just going to squeeze my butt. So I'm imagining same type of pressure where everything is moving in towards the center, the midline of my body. But now I'm really squeezing my butt. And I'm feeling myself maybe lift a little inch off of the chair, just a little higher. And release. Good, let's do it again. It's not a big movement, but it's also not very easy if you're really putting your mind to it and giving it a nice squeeze and release. Good, let's do one more. Squeeze. Really start to feel that tension, that tightness, that power in the muscles. And release. Awesome. Shake it out. Just take a nice deep breath in and out. Good. We're going to take our arms, open them up into our window pose. So this is another really good exercise. I love doing this one. It's one of my favorites. We do it for our posture. So I've got my arms at a 90 degree angle, my wrists over my elbows, my elbows trying to get to about my shoulder height. And now I'm going to stick my chin forward. And I'm going to pull it back, and it's the pulling back that we're really caring about. We're lengthening the back of our neck. We're pulling our ears over our shoulders. And we're trying to correct all of that slouching posture that we might sometimes slip into. Good. Stick it forward, feel the difference, and pull it back. Nice long. One last time. Stick it forward and pull it back. Good. Let those arms come down. Just give your head a little side to side tilt. Nice and easy. You can turn and look over your shoulders. Starting to feel a little bit more loose, a little bit more energy this morning. And with that, take that energy and send it on for the rest of your day. Thanks so much for working out with me. I'll see you in class next time.